Impress texture with bubble wrap is one of my favorite texture creating techniques. Super fun, super easy, and I get to play with bubble wrap. Now, from this point on in painting, I refer to it as a texture tool, okay? So don't pop my texture tools. So obviously I'm just gonna use a small piece. I don't need a huge sheet of bubble wrap, all as much fun as it is, okay? Now, there are different sizes of bubble wrap, right? So you could get like those really big bubbles and whatnot, and small bubbles, okay? So it doesn't really matter which one you have. There's also different kinds of shapes of bubble wrap. I've seen that start to come out a lot more, where some are more rectangular. Those are really super weird, okay, and hard to pop, so not as fun. But now, remember, bubble wrap is a plastic, right? So that's very similar to the impressed texture with plastic wrap, in that it's going to push the paint away, almost like a resist, okay? But it's going to do it in a very patterned way. And the nice thing about this is because these little bubbles are going to push and bend and give with weight, they create different shapes within there. So I'm gonna go ahead and load up some red, okay? So again, I started with a wet into wet. That's primarily how I start all these techniques, is wet into wet, because then it doesn't dry so quickly. If the paper dries really, really fast, or my pigment dries really fast, the technique doesn't work. So you have to consider that when you're working with these things. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and load this up just a little bit more, get a little bit more water in here just so it doesn't dry out too much. Gonna add a little bit of the phthalo blue in here. Okay, just so you could see as the colors start to mix, right? Also, thick to thin in terms of what happens when I have thicker paint and I have thinner paint, right? So I'm gonna see what happens. I'm playing. Once again, that's so important when you're learning how to paint, is not being afraid to play, right? All right, cool. So I added some in there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and push this in on top of it. Now, because it's clear, I could kind of manipulate it, right? And you can kind of see what's happening, right? I could bend it. I could do whatever I want with it. I'm just going to lay it flat because that looks like fun. Now, just like the other things, I have to wait for it to dry. So since I have to wait for it to dry, I'm going to put a little bit of a weight on it and leave it alone for a few minutes, okay? Then I'll come back to it and see what it looks like. So let's see what happened. I'm going to go out now that I've waited. I take off my weight and I'm going to peel this back and check that out. Still a little wet in that area, but that's fine. See, look at that nice little texture in there. Okay, that's super fun, right? You could see what it starts to do, how it just kind of pushes away the pigment. It could actually create little halos inside of there depending on how much air you got in there to push away the pigment and keep it away, right? Notice these are still a little bit wet, so if I would have kept them on there a little bit longer, I could have gotten a different texture. The other thing too is now I could actually take this and I could actually push that onto something else, okay, and create a different texture. All right, so to show you what I mean by that is I could come in here with another piece of paper and I could push it down and create a different texture. See, so that's one way you could do it too, is you could actually impress it into the wet paper and wet paint, or you could impress it directly from the bubble wrap. So super fun.